The research center PSI in Switzerland. Idyllic outside, efficient inside. There are complicated instruments and machinery everywhere. But even though it's reminiscent of a mixture of a nuclear power plant and a shipyard, it's one of the few places in the world where you can study something of the very smallest, how different materials are built up atom by atom. The research is world-class, and Danish scientists pass by frequently. Their research could end up saving society billions in energy bills and the environment from tons of CO2. Next to the River Ahr in Switzerland, a tributary of the Rhine in the middle of the idyll of the Alps, lies the Paul Scherrer Institute, or just PSI. And there's also a Dane, on a sponsored bicycle. Astrid Tranum Römer is a master's student at the Nanoscience Center at the Niels Bohr Institute at the University of Copenhagen. She's part of one of the Danish research teams working at PSI.
The right height is the smaller one, so we need to double check.
Her team is doing research on superconductors, materials that conduct electricity without a loss of energy. Research that's been going on for 20 years, and researchers from the entire world are involved.
Det er meget spændende. Især sådan et projekt her, som optager så mange forskellige grupper hele verden over. Så der er hele tiden masser, der er mange grupper, der finder ud af noget nyt, som man skal sætte sig ind i, og så prøver man så at tænke på nogle gode muligheder for at få belyst nogle ting, som man ikke ved endnu.
Astrid and the other researchers' work is more important than ever. For if they find the solution for transferring energy from the power plant to the consumers without a loss of energy, it would markedly reduce the world's energy consumption. A large portion of the energy that disappears is due to the resistance found in ordinary copper wires. In order to learn about superconductors, one needs to take a closer look at the neutrons, one of the building blocks of an atom. Neutrons are shot into various materials, and by studying how the neutrons scatter when they hit the material, the researchers can work out how the material's built up. And they learn where the magnetic atoms are and what they do. This is important because it's the magnetic atoms and magnetism that form the foundation for making an efficient and practical superconductor. It's also by studying the magnetic structures that researchers can find the answer to how one makes superconductors that can function at room temperature. Niels Beck Christensen is a senior scientist at RISU DTU and PSI and part of the scientific milieu that does research in superconductivity and magnetism.
Altså, udover vi alle sammen er nogle legebørn, så er det også interessant at prøve at forstå, hvordan naturen... Det er interessant at forstå, hvordan naturen hænger sammen. Hvordan kan det være, at magnetiske stoffer overhovedet bliver magnetiske? Hvad er det for en mekanisme, der ligger bag? Og hvordan kan det være forskelligt fra det ene materiale til det andet materiale, til det tredje materiale?
In order to be able to research neutrons at all, a lot of neutrons need to be produced, and central to this is the proton accelerator. It's this that brings scientists from around the world to PSI in Switzerland. There aren't many places where one can get a very high number of protons up at the speed one can get in Switzerland.
Det der sker her er at neutronerne efter at de er blevet accelereret op til 80% af lysets hastighed, det sker i bygningen ved siden af. Kommer ind i den her bygning i et niveau, som ligger under gulvniveau. Hvor efter de kommer ind i den her betonbygning ved siden af, og inde i den er der en cylinder, som er fyldt op med bly. Når de højenergetiske protoner så rammer blyet, så skaber de en masse neutroner, som vi reducerer i hastighed og sender i retning af instrumenterne.
It's along these long pipes that the neutrons are shot out to the various research teams and instruments that are placed in the large machine hall. One of the two Danish instruments is called Rita 2 and was originally built in Denmark at RISU. But when the reactor was closed, Rita was moved to Switzerland, and in exchange, Danish researchers are allowed to use it a third of the time. Astrid was one of those who was chosen to participate because her thesis lies within the field of superconductors and magnetism.
Jeg kommer her ned med en krystal, som jeg så skal undersøge på mikroskopisk plan, hvilket man kan gøre ved hjælp af neutronspredning.
Today, researchers know why some materials become superconductors when they get close to absolute zero, which is minus 273 degrees Celsius. But the researchers don't yet know why the best of the newly developed ceramic superconductors with copper in them become superconductors at much higher temperatures, up to minus 109 degrees Celsius. The relatively high temperature makes the new ceramic superconductors much more useful for practical purposes. And that's why researchers like Astrid are looking for the answer to why they can superconduct at a temperature well over absolute zero.
Vi vil gerne undersøge, hvordan det kan være, at man kan have superledning i de her kobberoxidplaner, som ligger inde i krystallen. Og det viser sig, at man får superledende faser, når man modificerer krystallen lidt. Og det har været noget, som har været udsat for intens forskning i 20 år. Men man er ikke kommet til noget svar endnu, og så det er vi meget interesseret i at prøve at finde.
It's something of an understatement to say that the researchers are interested in finding out why the material is superconducting. The researchers who come up with key breakthroughs and can explain why and how the material is already superconducting at minus 109 degrees is as good as assured to win the Nobel Prize and be written down in history. And part of that research is happening, as already mentioned, in the Danish-built instrument Rita 2. Rita 2 is specially constructed to look at magnetism and the magnetic structures in different materials. The researchers are working on investigating the superconducting properties of a crystal, which has been cooled down, placed in a cryostat, or a cooling machine, on Rita 2.
Herinde har vi så selve instrumentet. Neutronerne rammer først en såkaldt monokromator, som er inde i den grønne cylinder her, og som virker på den måde, at den udvælger retning og energi på de neutroner, som vi så sender ind på vores prøve, som er inde i den store magnet her, 15 tesla magnet. Det er et meget, meget kraftigt magnetfelt, og prøven er så nedkølet til en temperatur, som er lige over det absolutte nulpunkt. Og prøven er nedkølet til cirka minus 271 grader Celsius. Neutronerne, som bliver spredt fra prøven, rammer så ind i detektortanken, som jeg nu vil åbne. Neutronerne kommer ind af det her hul og rammer den serie af krystaller, som sidder her, som vi kalder for en analysator. Og analysatoren virker ligesom monokromatoren på den måde, at den udvælger retning og energi på de neutroner, som vi sender ind imod detektoren, som sidder her om bag.
When the neutrons have been counted in the detector, the researchers know something about how fast the neutron was moving and in which direction.
Indtil videre er vi jo stadig ved meget kolde temperaturer, selvom vi kalder det høje temperatur superledning. Så der er noget vej at gå, men der bliver hele tiden fundet nye stoffer. Og hvis man finder noget, der rent faktisk kan bruges, er det jo et stærkt på den måde, at man ikke har noget energitab ved at lede gennem en superleder. Altså så strøm gennem en superleder taber ikke energi undervejs. Og det vil jo være et super stærkt værktøj i mange sammenhænge.
Even though it's basic research that Astrid and Niels are doing in Switzerland, there is still a clear aim.
I det moderne samfund har vi mange steder, hvor vi spilder en masse varme. Og målet med den type forskning og lave den type devices er, at kunne lave noget teknologi, som gør, at man spilder meget mindre varme, som om du vil er mere energirigtigt eller mere miljørigtigt. Så der er mindre tab til omgivelserne af energi, som vi ikke bruger.
The research can not only come closer to the mystery of superconductors, neutron research is itself the starting point for a number of projects that have medicinal or practical purposes. For example, researchers from the University of Aarhus are doing neutron research using Rita 2, where they're investigating thermoelectric materials that can convert heat to electrical energy and the other way round. Yet another research area with great potential, because there are many places, for example in car motors, where heat is generated and not currently used. The goal is to develop materials which can convert, for example, waste heat from motors into energy. So neutron research, like here at PSI, is absolutely central when researchers need to understand how different materials behave the way they do. Once the understanding is in place, it's possible to develop the intelligent materials of the future. And these materials will perhaps be developed very close to Denmark. The largest neutron source in the world, up to 100 times more powerful than the one at PSI, is going to be built in Lund, near Malmö, in Sweden. The project is called ESS, European Spallation Source, and researchers from the Niels Bohr Institute in Copenhagen will be close collaboration partners.